Okay, so we are going to see how an oil drop can be held stationary in space. Okay, right. The oil drop is given charges. Just imagine it is given positive charges. Okay, and there is a positive plate at the bottom. And a negative plate at the top. And this positive plate and negative plate together will create what? Will create an electric field. And just as the oil drop tries to fall down, you know, it is falling down because of what? Falling down because of gravity, right? It is being repelled by electric field in the upward direction. Electric field is what? Electric force is Q times E. Let me repeat. So I have an oil drop. The oil drop has to be kept stationary in space. It has to stay afloat. Okay. So when you keep an oil drop here, that it tends to fall down. Why is it falling down? Because gravity is pulling the body downwards. Okay. The oil drop is falling down because of gravity, mg. Okay. I'm going to balance this gravity somehow. How can I do this? You know, I can give charges to the drop. See this now. This plus is repelling plus in the upward direction now. And the electrostatic force here is QE. It is an important question for bots also. I told you in the last class. Now, these are balancing each other. QE is equal to mg is the condition. QE is what? This plus is repelling plus in the upward direction. Minus is attracting plus in this upward direction. So both the forces are in the upward direction. So the net electrostatic force is what? Net electrostatic force is in the upward direction. Understand? And that is written as QE here, no? So QE is being balanced by mg here. Tell me, and we wrote one equation here. Q could be written as any. Because that was the very first equation you learned this year. Electric charge, you know? If at all it exists as what? Integral multiple of electronic charge. Q is equal to ne. Okay. So I'm writing it as ne into e is equal to. What is this mass? We even wrote an equation for this. Mass by volume is density. Hope you remember. Mass by volume is density. Cross multiply. What is mass now? Volume into density. Volume is 4 by 3 pi r cube into rho. So I could put it over here. That makes it what? 4 by 3 pi r cube rho g. Trust me, this is one of the most important questions around. Okay, they might ask different questions based on this. They'll ask you to find the number of electrons on the drop. They ask you to find the number of electrons on the drop, n is to be calculated. And if the question is to find the total charge on the drop, total charge is Q is equal to ne. And the question is to find the electric field required to hold the oil drop. It is E that is to be calculated. And then what? They might even ask what? The radius of oil drop. The question is there in chapter and addition exercises. Question number 2. Get an expression for radius of oil drop. And then density of oil. These are all probable questions. There are 5 questions altogether. 1. Number of electrons on the drop. E is electronic charge. E is electric field required. Then what? R is radius of oil drop. And density is rho is density of oil. Okay. And in the next chapter, you will see electric field as voltage by distance. Okay. Voltage by distance. So they might even ask you to find what? The voltage required. So what is the cell to be connected here? No? You have to connect a cell here. What is the cell to be connected? In such case, you will replace this E with V by D. Electric field can be written as V by D. Understand? So they might ask you to find the potential difference to be applied. Or the distance between the plates. So there are 7 questions altogether. Question number 1, number of electrons on the drop. Question number 2, charge on the drop. Question number 3, electric field required. Question number 4, radius of oil drop. Question number 5, density of oil. And again, the last one, potential difference required 6. And the distance between the plates 7. We have written till this point. Did you understand this? Say so now, please.